a la Shmoop. In 1976, Alex Haley published a popular and award-winning novel about race, emancipation, and basic human rights. Oh, so the book isn't what we're talking about now? Sorry, our bad. There we go. Apparently you're here to learn about an entirely different type of root. Let's look at an example. Here's the square root of 9. It's just the number 9 inside of a funny-looking symbol that resembles a checkmark. Here's what this symbol is asking. What number, when multiplied by itself, equals 9? Well, if you've ever drawn a tic-tac-toe board, you should know that the answer is 3. A root is really just the opposite of an exponent. 3 squared equals 9, and the square root of 9 equals 3. Things get more complicated, however. Oh, goody. Not every root is a square root. You can also have a cubed root, like this one. The 3 is telling you there is a number that will fit this formula. You can plug in 2 to make this equation complete. So we can say that 2 is the cube root of 8. You can do the same with higher roots as well, although you're now entering serious headache territory. If you don't feel like drawing the root symbol, roots can also be expressed as exponents. If something is raised to the power of 1/2, it's the same as a square root. If it has an exponent of 1/3, then we're dealing with a cube root. Be careful, though, when negative numbers enter the picture. Those guys can mess you up. For example, there can never be a square root of a negative, as multiplying any two numbers always gives you a positive result. You can, however, have a cube root of a negative number. We know there are a lot of rules to keep in mind. We hope this video wasn't too painful for you. At least, not as painful as the root canal.
Oh! No! No!